Yes,
so,
it is.
So they want to avoid the matchup. So Omni is against Kanka. So that's the idea behind the pick. They want to have this kind of like matchup where Omni will beat Kanka.
Get many opportunities to play Kanka versus Omni mid. Like,
yeah. It's kind of similar how you asked me about the Pango versus Batrider.
Oh.
Puppy is going to be body blocked up pretty heavily here. Torrent is going to be able to land on the gyrocopter. That'll slow down some of the damage, but Puppy may still fall. In fact, he does. Mushi picks up the first blood here, winning the mid lane and seem to be doing all right for themselves in bottom.
Haven't had to even use the Pango quite yet.
Oh, Bada stuck in. Here comes the ball. He's got a Tusk Pango combination. Herself. He could just constantly bounce around these walls. Is going to be able to nail the Kunkka a couple times as well, but they get into the shrine, and now Jabs is going to be the one in trouble, and Ice can do nothing to be able to save you here, Jabs. So just takes all that movement damage. Fada thinking about going for the kill here. The homing missile as well as the glimpse is going to put him in awkward position with a call down as well. They've got the snowball to further stun him, and Fada is dead. Mineski are just pressuring on all sides here. Every single lane, they've got a core occupying that. Oh, the Rolling Thunder. Not going to land on mid one here. Managed to juke it a little bit. And as long as we don't have a bash from Roshan.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Mid one's got a DD.
Oh, nice Fissure block though with a double damage. Guardian Angel's going to be activated by Moon. He's going to challenge Ace here. Actually goes for the Purification. Nuke onto him, but the boat's going to come back and brings him low enough. They've got the Sticky Napalm there as well. So Moon's just not going to be able to outrun this.
Ports are doing much better on the side of Seeker right now.
Did you see the Bloodseeker throw the Blood Rage onto the Batrider? That has got to be so scary when you have Sticky Napalm stacks on you. Boat is going to completely whiff there. I'm not sure what that was. Rolling Thunder now canceled by the Rupture. He's going to have to TP out here. Ninja Boogie going to be caught. And Moon might be able to take advantage of this one. It's going to almost bring mid one down, but fortunately the Chen Heal goes out.
Blood
mid one now trying to outrun the homing missile. It's going to hit him eventually, but it's not enough to get the kill. Snowball in. Ace is going to die, but he gets the kill on Ninja Boogie. No, he's not. He's not going to die. Fada's on his team. He's actually got full backup here. It's going to be the Tusk who's going to be caught out. He does have a shard. Trying to separate himself, not going to be able to do so. Ace trying to run him down now. He does have 8 magic stick charges and a snowball coming up in 2 seconds. Can he juke this long enough for the Omni Knight to be able to save the day? Purification, no, it's not going to go off Ace. And then Secret just kind of play around in a 4v5 Secret.
Oh, there's the blink.
Oh, the Rolling Thunder hits a couple of heroes here. Ended up getting stuck onto the cliff. He's going to have to bounce down somehow, but here comes the call down. Managed to nail Ace. Into the call down he goes, and that should be enough magic damage. Mid one still kind of holding on the side because the boat's coming in. They're thinking about whether or not they can get this kill. Nice place by Ice. Jumping down to low ground, but the last is going to be able to pull him back. Still trying to keep him alive, though. Guardian Angel and Rappel. Now the snowball in, and they're going to try and blow up mid one, but here comes an Echo Slam. Holding him in. The silence is going to go off as well. Mid one has a lot of low HP heroes to work off of, and he's going to kill the Tusk first. Gets a little bit of HP off of that one, and the rest of the team retreating, leaving Moon behind, but he is going to be able to complete his TP out. Killing thing.
Don't you just not heal if he's Spirit Vessel?
I mean, that's what I believe.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's how that works. Oh, yeah. Mineski, though, they're smoked up themselves. They
might
made
be able
that play.
To get a good initiation. They did finally make that play. The smoke is going to pop here. They're going to go
nice
on for Puppy first, as well as go for the glimpse back onto mid one. This is a good combination. Rolling Thunder on through. He's going to nail mid one, blinking into him to make sure
he gets that
damage before the Rupture goes back to Puppy to finish him off.
Cool hero. Toss out hits.
Yeah. So, he goes to SNY. Oh. Do you think he goes, the really satanic kind of build? Rolling Thunder actually stopping Fada and managed to get the backfly. That disrupts everybody. The Ice Shard's gonna hold these people in.
Chaotic.
And now he managed to get right in the middle of everything with a snowball landing onto, and they're gonna finish off the Bloodseeker pretty easily, get the glimpse back on a Puppy. That's 4 down. I have no idea if Ice meant for that to happen.
That was unbelievable.
The Rolling Thunder hitting Fada.
Yeah, Secret.
6k gold leads and Mineski.
What's your response here? They've got a BKB on this Batrider, so you
Fissure
have to
block.
Be careful. Mushi can just get dragged back
into
the Pure Force.
Yeah, that's exactly what they're going to do. They're going to try and pull him as far as possible, but the Rolling Thunder is going to come through. The BKB from the Batrider will protect him, but Ice can't really get a good roll in. He's trying to go for a mid one right now, but finally Mushi does end up going down. Mid one is now going to turn against Ice, who's actually sent back to base by Puppy. So he will return in a moment, especially with Pango being knocked up in the air by the Torrent. He's going to be able to get her out of range of that one, while Mushi goes for Ace. He's going to be able to bring him down. Puppy's going to be up next. Mid one back into the fight, but all these heroes are far too healthy from Mineski for Grimm to be able to do much, especially if they lose more. Yaptor needs to be able to get a good Echo Slam in. Finally gets one, but it's only on Ice, and they walk out of the silence. Finally gets the Fissure down, but Midwan is going to be able to take down at least one. Now Fada is going to be in some trouble. Pull back right as he was about to land with Shield Crash. Ice is quite low. Midwan is playing in and out of this team fight. He knows these heroes are low, and all he has to do is pick and poke at them until they finally fall. Now the silence is going to go in. Midwan committing a little bit more onto Bushi. Here comes the boat. Oh no, the Shield Crash! It managed to finish him off. The Blood Rage. It meant that Midwan dies so quickly.
And
Bushi, he's going to stay alive. The heal comes out from Moon just in time, and Ice has Ace at his mercy. He's going to be stunned up by Yapzor. Torrent follow up, but no, he actually jumps out of that one. Goes for the Rolling Thunder, blinks right on top of him. Hits him, and TP's on his way out. You can't stop that one, Yapzor. Moon keeps on making his way away. Bushi protecting Moon, just like Moon protected Bushi, and he's just going to need that protection too. The Repel protecting me against his magic damage. Bada going to keep on trying to chase him as much as possible here. Slowing him down with the sticky napalm, has a blink dagger up, so he'll just keep on chasing here. But Moon will be able to heal him up a little bit more. That's why Mushi's going to turn and fight. But the distance, a little bit of separation here, but now Fada's going to be slowed down. The homing missile's going to hit him. He needs to send back from the Chen, but it's not going to happen fast enough. Mineski win the long brawl here at the bottom lane and will go right back to taking those objectives.
Yeah, with two heroes dead now.
Who's going to pick that one? Got it.
Pingo has... Oh, he's gonna pop
he's
gonna the ult, he just can't in there.
Yeah, he's trying to go for some of these heroes, won't be able to get it. Now the pullback, actually, and they'll nail Fadi. Just keeps on pouncing around, making sure that Tika can't really get the rescue Fadi. He's gonna be able to get the lasso in now, but the repel's already down on Ice, so he will still be kind of protected.
Oh, he's got Greaves
they put
too.
Him up on the high ground, but he can easily get back down. He does have a swashbuckle to be able to get to the low ground, dodging that silence. The Guardian Angel protects him for a time as well. Moon just playing in the trees, making sure he can't be targeted. What a great ice shot.
What an ice shot.
All these in, and now the jump forward with a snowball. They're gonna be able to finish off all three of these heroes. Ice. Actually, Ace might be able to get out with the BKB teleport. Barely makes it.
Yeah, had to cancel his TP.
Oh, the Aetherlens Yule Scepter managed to snag him on the high ground. He's gonna be slowed down enough for Ice to be able to pick up that kill. Three dead from Secret. A high ground push imminent for Mineski.
And when he goes for the Rolling Thunder with that Lincolns, they can't really do anything about him.
Yeah.
They he just creates just, all the space in the world, gives them everything. They have perfect vision. This is going to be, at minimum, a second set of racks. They might even just go for the Megas here, and that is indeed what they're going to do. And they're just going to call it.
Oof.
That is Pango.
That is indeed.
That was cool. Super glad you got to cast that one. I learned a lot about that hero.
And that is also Secret taking another loss. They are now 3-2, I believe, groups. While Mineski,